Butler defending the submission attempt here from Galvao. Now Butler looking for top position, but look at the extension on that arm. My word, that's gonna hurt. Jab from Butler. Galvao's been training with tall, long, reachy opponents, sparring with them to learn to overcome the massive height and reach differential.
A lot of times when you get two high-level grapplers, such as we have here, it comes down to striking. But both these guys want to stay on top. That's where this match is going to be decided. Who can avoid the bottom position?
We're seeing a striking contest early between two big martial artists. The size of the back on Galvao, you could screen a movie on it. Edges forward, the Brazilian. You just get the sense with this one, Mitch, that fireworks could happen at any moment.
That's true, especially with Butler leaving his chin up like that. You can see Galvao, he's got a bit of a height disadvantage. Takes one there quite low.
They continue in the opening round between Galvao and Butler. Beautiful two-punch combination down the center corridor there for Gilberto Galvao. High kick from Butler, tries to take the head.
Jake's got to use that jab. He's got to keep Galvao away, keep him guessing. Doesn't want Galvao to get comfortable. See how he's throwing that huge right hand. Some knees coming from Butler.
High knee off the right from Butler. Galvao forces him back against the cage. Tries to hook the leg, get the takedown here. Gilberto does so. Top position for the BJJ stylist.
This will be interesting to see if Galvao can hold Butler down. I know from firsthand experience, Butler is a beast on the ground. He's gonna wanna pop back up as soon as he can, but he has to let go of that head. That head is, I mean, unless he's got a really sneaky one-arm guillotine, that arm over the head isn't gonna do anything for him. You see Galvao trying to adjust his position, trying to suck away the hips, but Jake's just popping right back up.
Galvao with monstrous strength. What's Gilberto looking to do here, Dragon?
He's keeping his head nice and high. You can see he's gonna try to drop down. He's trying to sweep that leg out, takes that leg out, and he spins him around, doesn't quite get it. Now Butler's got the underhooks on that right side. Now he's gonna be able to swivel him around, put Galvao against the cage. Oh, that was a nice takedown from Galvao. You can see Jake Butler was trying to go for the outside trip on that side, but Galvao just muscled him over. He's got to have such a tremendous squeeze with arms those size.
Half-guard position here for Gilberto Galvao, the Brazilian, on the top of the American wrestler. A place where a wrestler does not want to be, Mitch, on their back.
They never want to be on their ground, but Jake Butler is a complete martial artist. He can do it all. He can grapple, so he has no problem competing out of his guard. But that's, you can just see him trying to hold on there to avoid any ground and pound. And this is a smart move. Make Galvao try to gas out his arms, get tired. You know, those big muscles eat up a lot of oxygen. So if Jake can make him work as much as possible in these struggles and these scrambles, you know, he can probably pay dividends later in the match.
Looking for some ground and pound. Here is the Brazilian from half guard position, dropping the elbows. Hunting after that far arm now of Butler, Mitch.
Yeah, he's gotta keep a care, because you can see Butler trying. Oh, here comes the, you can see one more rip, and he's gonna extend that arm. Butler's gotta be careful. This is a bad spot to be in when you got those massive arms of Galvao trying to take your arm off.
Butler defending the submission attempt here from Galvao. Now Butler looking for top position, but look at the extension on that arm. My word, that's gonna hurt.
Galvao's trying to extend his arm to touch into the back of his head, but Jake Butler toughs it out.
And now Butler inside a half guard top position, ground and pound from the American wrestler. Here he comes, Butler, his big return to the cage.
How much energy did Galvao expend trying to rip that arm off? Now Butler's on top in the half guard doing his best. See, that was the struggle, that was the battle. Who's gonna do the best when they're on bottom?
Mitchell, looks impressive to have muscles that size of Galvao, but does it drain the energy from you having that big?
It does. I've never been that big, so I don't know what that feels like, Michael, but I can imagine, and just from exercise science, it is debilitating. Once all those muscles have been contracted and squeezed and flexed, they just lose all their energy. All that ATP is gone from your body.
How about Butler being in a position like this on the back of Galvao? How much does that drain the Brazilian?
You can see him standing up, so all that pressure's on his legs. Jake Butler's a big dude, but now this is gonna be the tell. Who is gonna come off the stool?
How did you gauge? Ooh, a nice left hand. That was a left hand from Galvao. Oh, did he blow a knee? Did Butler blow a knee? He took a left hand, and he may have blown a knee as well, Mick.
Gilberto Galvao!
Great win there for Gilberto Galvao, who is looking to have a big year in 2018. And coming up next, the action continues.